In this video, I'm going to talk about the input files for the Omics Playground platform. I will start by talking about how to correctly name the input files, then about the structures of the files, and finally, I will show you where you can find more information regarding formatting. So I'll start by talking about the naming of the files. So there are three input files that the platform accepts. Two of them are compulsory, i.e. the samples and the counts file, whereas the contrast file is optional. So you can generate that through the platform rather than creating it yourself. And I strongly recommend actually you use the platform interface to generate this file. This, however, you need to prepare yourself. Now, when it comes to the naming, you can really pick any name you want as long as each of the files contains the words samples, counts, and contrasts in them. So for example, you know, if you want to rename this to be a more specific, more meaningful name, you can say, for example, cancer, but it has to contain the word samples in it. And the same goes for counts. It should match the same name, except it has to contain the word counts in it. Now, when it comes to the actual structure of the files, they're all pretty straightforward. I'll start with the counts.csv file. So here, the first column will contain the gene or protein IDs. The platform is fairly flexible in the format of the gene or protein names that you choose, and I will show you at the end where you can find more information about the accepted format. But they should always be in the first column. And then in each of the following columns, you will have your individual samples with corresponding protein protein intensities or read counts. And it starts with the actual name of the samples in the first cell. And then in each of the following cells, you will input the read counts or protein intensities for a given protein or gene. So in this case, A2M, and these are the corresponding values. Now, there are a couple of points that you need to pay attention to here. First of all, you need to be careful in the formatting of your sample names. The platform doesn't accept certain characters such as slashes, asterisks, or greater and smaller than. So this should not be used. As a rule of thumb, it's better to use either hyphens or underscores when you produce your sample names. Also, please do not use spaces. So this is not good. You should instead use, as I said, underscores or hyphens. An important note about the formatting of the numbers. The platform accepts international numbering formats, but if you start working with some of your local numbering formats, for example, the Dutch numbering systems, this can cause problems with the platform. So I strongly suggest, if you're using a local numbering format, that you convert it to an international numbering format such as this one, or you can also convert it into the scientific numbering format, which is works absolutely fine with the platform. Next, we have the samples files. This is the file that contains the actual phenotypic information about your samples. The structure is that in the first column, you will have your sample IDs, and they have to match the sample IDs you have in your counts file. And then in each of the following column, you will add your different phenotypes. In this case, I have, for example, sample ID, disease, body mass index, ethnicity, disease outcome, age group, and tumor size. These two you can ignore for now. They are actually generated by the platform, automatically by the platform. but they will probably not be present in your input file. So let's focus on the phenotypes that you would normally prepare yourself. So when it comes to naming the different phenotypes, obviously give it something meaningful. So in this case, for example, you can see I separated samples between glioblastoma and healthy, or I have ethnicity, Caucasian, Asian, Hispanic, and so on. It's very important, again, to remember not to use any special characters when you either name your phenotypes or when you label each of individual samples. So don't do something like this or something like this, because these are not accepted symbols. So if you want to join names, do something like this. Use underscores or eventually hyphens are fine too. Now, very important is also to remember that the platform doesn't accept numeric values as phenotypes. So for example, you can see that when it comes to age, I didn't input the actual age of a patient, which for example could be say 50 years old, but I used a range, so in this case 50 to 64. And this is because 50 to 64 is not recognized as a number, it's recognized as a non-numerical character. So, and this will allow the platform to work with the data. So remember, whenever you have any numerical values, could be age, could be height, could be weight, or in this case also BMI, you have to convert that into a range or a category. So in this case, for example, I converted the BMI into categories: obese, normal, overweight, underweight, and so on, rather than using the actual value. If you input any numerical values, the platform will likely throw up an error and you will have to correct that. The final input file is the contrast.csv file. Again, it follows a format similar to the samples files. You will have in the first column your sample IDs, and then in each one of the following columns you will have your different pairwise comparisons. So you can see here, for example, my first pairwise comparison is glioblastoma versus healthy, and I labeled all the samples that are glioblastoma with the name glioblastoma and all the samples that are controlled as healthy. But I could have easily used any other naming systems. I could have called, for example, the healthy ones just H and the glioblastomas just G. That's absolutely fine. You don't need to stick to these specific names. However, one important factor in the naming of the pairwise comparisons is that all of them need to contain this element here, underscore versus underscore. You cannot produce any of the pairwise comparisons without that element. So this will not work. It only will work if you include underscore versus underscore. Otherwise, you can name the rest of the pairwise comparison any way you want. So I could, for example, change this to G versus H, and that's absolutely fine with the platform as long as it contains this element here, underscore versus underscore. So for the final part of this video, I'm gonna direct you now to our documentation, which you can find here, and specifically to the basic data preparation documentation. This is where you can find more details about how to prepare your input files. And in particular, if you go to the section checks before uploading, it will tell you which special characters are allowed and which ones are not allowed for the different input files. And as you can see in the note here, we cannot always guarantee that special characters will work. As such, please avoid using them, also avoid using empty spaces, and instead use underscores to connect different components of your naming. I invite you to check this page if you have more questions. Otherwise, you can always get in touch with our support staff.